Hi, hello friends, welcome to World Explorer India. Today let us discuss about principles of communication in intensive care units. In intensive care unit we see there is a lot of chaos, lot of noise of alarms and staff running here and there, lot of emergencies, patients suddenly getting sick, there is uncertainty. So out of all these situations, we are handling with the patients, the most vital part is the communication. How we are going to communicate with each other and with the patient and with the relatives and with the machines. These are all the things which we should keep in mind. And based on all of this, I have made this video. Now, the first point is machine or the patient. Do you rely the machine or the patient? Always better to assess the patient, not the machine. Machines is not always correct. Machines do lie. For example, if a patient SpO2 is suddenly crashing down from SpO2 of 94 to SpO2 to 60. So the possible reason may be you might have tied the BP cuff onto the same hand in which you are monitoring the SpO2. So because of which there is error in the monitor. So it is better to assess the patient, not the monitor. Monitors do supplement, but your experience and your critical thinking skills will make you assess the patient in a better manner. Always talk to the patient and assess the patient and take supplementary help from the machines. Do family members need to be communicated? Yes. The family members, it may be blood relatives or the friends or any other person who is actively involved in the patient care. Now, there is compassion fatigue or caregiver burnout which will happen to the family members because they are leaving their routine, they are working very hard for the patient, and there is uncertainty in the condition of a patient. So in keeping a view of all these situations, the relatives may experience stress and it may even lead to burnout. So here I am giving a principle ABC, that is ask, break the news and clarify. Asking is, if the patient is facing any new complaints, any process improvement which the patient may suggest, any comfort measures enhancement which we can do for the patient, and how we can communicate with the family members, and what is the mode of communications. Nowadays there is telecommunication which being used. So many of the relatives are not being allowed into the ICU. They may be seeing through a television, sitting somewhere in the corner of hospital. So in such situation, how we are maintaining the communication with the patients? And if any information patient want to share to us and any clarification he or she need about the health status, these all things which we should keep in mind while asking the information from the patients. Break the news. Be very straightforward. Explain all the treatment options available and explain the prognosis in an easy language, understandable, but it should be very short and crisp. Do not explain in a very lengthy manner. Clarify. Patient or family member may need more information. Means the earlier information which you have said to the patient is not understood by the patient, or they may need much more information. Never overburden the patient with the information. Make it very short and crisp. But if the patient is insisting you to tell more about the condition, then it is better to explain. Be attentive to the emotions, whether the patients or relatives of the patient are satisfied with your information. If you still see there is anxiety in the relatives, if there is some doubt in the patients better to ask them and clarify the doubts. It is always better to assess the emotions of a patient. You should reflect back. For example, it seems you are angry. It seems you are happy. Such statements will help the patient to understand their own emotions. What would have been done if you were in my place? Such type of questions the patients will ask to us. So I understand how difficult to handle this situation. This is how we can gently answer to such questions. You are so fortunate to have a caring family member who are responding very immediately for your needs. So you are crediting the relatives. So this will even soothe the patient. Reassurance, is it too early or too late? Never be too early, but never be too late. If you are giving reassurance too early, you doesn't even know what the patient situation is going to be in the next 15 minutes. Because the conditions like myocardial infarction, this can be developed in any point of time. So such situations will even complicate the life of a patient. So it is better never reassure early, but never too late. Listen more to the patient. Do not overburden with the information is the basic principle in ICU. Do you have personal problems? Never share with the patient, because patient is already having lot of problems, and if you are going to share your problems with the patient, it is going to cause overburden to the patient. So never share your personal problems or discuss in front of the patients. Will the patient completely recover? You might have seen such patients. Was there any improvement in such conditions? Can you give guarantee for the life? Better be prepared for such questions and how to handle this situation in a gentle manner. Because we know the patient condition varies depend on the present situation and previous history. Some of the patients do repent that I should have got treated earlier, I have made a bad decision. So in such cases, you can reassure the patient that now you are in safe hands. Next is CPR or DNR. CPR is cardiopulmonary resuscitation, DNR is do not resuscitate. On the admission, if patient is insisting for DNR, you should not resuscitate the patient. And there is one more thing that is called as advance directive. The patient will have a chance to give directions about the treatment, whether he should go for such treatment modalities or not. For example, if patient is asking for not to keep on ventilator, or if patient is asking you not to resuscitate. So such type of directives should be respected. What if patient is not going to talk because of his condition? Who should be able to take the decision? Is it the relative or is it the patient? The advance directive. So such type of ethical issues should be dealt in a gentle manner. Informed consent, which we are being taken from the patient, should be in a language understandable by the patient. End of life care. Involve the family members as much as you can in the end of life care. Prepare the relatives, hope for the best and prepare for the worst. There is something known as anticipatory grieving. Anticipatory grieving means the relatives know that patient is having poor prognosis, so they have started grieving early, so they can adjust easily. But if you are hiding the information, if patient relative is suddenly get to know that patient is at very severe and he is not going to survive, they may get anger, and this anger can be shown on the staff of a patient. So it is better to handle the emotions in a proper manner. Whenever the patient is very sick, involve the family members even during end of life care. What after the loss? Allow sufficient time to grieve. Some of the patients do ask, is there any miracle? They are in a grief stage, denial, anger, bargaining, depression, acceptance. So because of anger, they may even ask such questions. And they do repent that they have done some mistakes. Allow them to involve in the care after the loss. Assist them in funeral arrangements. Give the ambulance details. Help them how to go for death registration certificates and summary. So by now I have covered majority of the issues related to communication in ICUs. So if you are professional in communication, you should be compassionate with a good competence, and your team communication should be accurate, and there should be patient family members involvement. Honest and straightforward communication and use of assistive aids is very much important. And one more thing here in team communications is shift handover. During change of shift, whether you are giving proper handover or not, whether you are missing something or whether something has not been updated, such things should be taken care of to avoid any loss to the patient. So first basic principle is do no harm to the patient is the first basic principle. So this communication methods which I have discussed is going to help in the planning of care in the ICU. If you like this video, do subscribe, share among your networks. Thank you.